Capos. Because guess what? You can't boast about you keeping the law 30. Because guess what? At some point you're gonna break it. So then we're boasting for. You understand? So boasting, we're boasting coming. That's why he said, he that glory, let him glory in Yahweh. Right? You understand? That's in the Jeremiah 9, something to read that, Jeremiah 9, 23. Right.
This is 2 Corinthians 17, then I jump into 2 Corinthians 2:17, and I jump into 3 and 1. It says, for we are not as many which corrupt the word of the Most High, but as of sincerity, but as of the Most High in the sight of Yahweh speak we, Mashiach. Do we begin again to commend ourselves, or need we as some others epistles of commendation to you, or letters of commendation from you? But then too, when I was having the altercation with Nate, when I say Nate, somebody come, Bishop Nate, it's Bishop Nate. Like, if I have to call you Bishop, you ain't no Bishop. A lot of us are coming all the way down and speak with bishops and deacons, and the men are the Lord. But yeah, it says, and verse 3, do we begin again to commend ourselves, or need we as some others epistles of commendation to you, or letters of commendation from you?
Yeah, because good. We are the glory, we are the glorify the Lord, Yahweh Hashem Yahushai. Scripture says, Father, glorify thy name. Alright? This what we do is to glorify the Lord. Scripture says we glorify the Lord in our body. You understand? That is why we're gonna try our best to keep God's to the best of our abilities and push this word in sincerity and truth. Because everything we do, it actually reflects upon the Most High. That's the reason the Lord called us to Zion 1, which means monument or reminder of the Most High. Alright? So we already scribbled in Isaiah 51, it says the Lord made bare his holy arm. That was put Israel in captivity. Alright? That's what the Lord said for his name's sake. So we had to make sure that the Lord have a good name. So we had to do this to the best of our abilities. Alright?
This is German.
And that is why we had to be serious.
This is Jeremiah 9:23. Thus saith Yahweh about Shem Yahushai, let not the wise man glory in his wisdom, neither let the mighty man glory in his might.
Yeah, hence the reason the Lord you call and told his sight. He said, don't let the wise man glory in his wisdom. Alright? Don't glory as though you can never receive it, like you just get it on your own. Alright? Don't glory on that. Well,
it says, not the rich man glory in his
because no, nobody on earth, no flesh can say I. The only person can say I is Yahweh.
That's right.
Everything that man received came from the Most High. Go back to Luke, verse 3:27. A man can receive nothing except if he came from the Lord.
Right.
When,
but let them that glory in this, that he understandeth, anoint me, that I am Yahweh, which exercise in love and kindness, judgment and righteousness.
Yeah, somebody give me Wisdom, Solomon chapter 2. Alright? Wisdom, Solomon chapter 2. Yeah, glory in the Lord. Glory that you know Yahweh Shem Yahushai, and that you are accepted of him. Alright? Wisdom, Solomon 2. That's not right.
Wisdom of Solomon 2:16. We are esteemed of him as counterfeits.
Yeah, that is how we esteem anybody who is pushing this whole truth. We esteem him as counterfeits. Go ahead.
He abstaineth from our ways as from filth.
Go ahead.
He pronounced the end of the just to be blessed.
Yeah, that is what we do. We prophesy that once you make it to the end, we're going to be a part of the kingdom to come.
Stand.
That's right.
Go ahead.
And make it his boast that Yahweh is his father.
Yeah, that is what we boast in. Make it our boast that Yahweh Shem Yahushai is our father.
That's right.
We boasted in. We boasted that I had this knowledge. Or, boast in things that we just received. Boast that, Yahweh Shem Yahushai for us.
That's
right. That is where we boast in. Alright? Because guess what? We ain't making all this kingdom yet. So we know we're going to be the end. Where we end going to be. That way the scripture says, one to you that desire the Lord. What end shall it be? So we had a hope. So then if it all goes back to hope, then guess what? We had to be humble.
And
we can't boast because boasting goes back to pride. Alright, the only thing we could boast on is that guess what? that wars of the other nations is false, and that our God, Yahweh Hashem El Shai, is a true and living God.
That's right. Word. That's something quick. This is Isaiah 10:15. Shall the axe boast itself against him that heweth therewith? Or shall the sword magnify itself against him that shaketh it?
Nice.
As
nice.
If the rod should shake itself against them that lift it up, or as if the staff should lift up itself, as if it would no wood. Therefore shall the Lord of hosts, stand among his fat ones leanness, and under his glory shall kindle the burning.
Yes, like the Lord just cannot diminish his strength. Alright, since you wanted to speak out against God, most high cannot take it off. That is why the Lord said that in terribleness and deceive it, go back to America, hold all most proud. God cannot take America down for that, because why? Because they proud and say, they always like to talk about American pride. Alright, they're thinking of the kingdom, all the things that they're doing against the nation of Israel, they're thinking that they're going to endure forever. But the most high Lord about to deliver the elect, and the Lord can take the so-called white man down, which are the Edomites,
that's right,
according to the Bible, can take it down and put it into slavery.
Man.
Alright, and after 1,000 years, can destroy all the face of the earth.
That's right.
Alright, go ahead. Because they have no way that the so-called white man gonna be in the kingdom. Go ahead. Shafa, yeah, Shafa.
In Psalm 75 and verse 5, he said, lift not up your horn on high, and speak not with a stiff neck. For promotion cometh neither from the east, nor from the west, nor from the south, but from Yahweh.
Yeah, that is where promotion comes from. Because the scripture said in Lamentation 2:17, it said the Lord, he exalted the horn of our adversaries. So the reason these nations over us is because the Most High put them in that position. That's that. So you can't boast and say that my hand had gotten released. You can't say that. Because wherever you have is all by the Most High.
Sure. Well, let me finish up here. Same. But from Yahweh is the judge. He put it down one and set it up another. For in the hand of Yahweh there is a cup, and the wine is red, it is full of mixture, and he pour it out of the same, but the dregs thereof, all the wicked of the earth shall wring them out and drink them.
Yeah, so the cup that we drank, alright, there's a cup that we drank, which going back to Jeremiah 49, we said that we were supposed to drink of that cup. Guess what? The nation's gonna drink of it.
Right.
Alright? They're gonna drink of that cup. And the Lord said they're gonna wring it out. So they're gonna make sure they get every last drop. Alright? Good.
This is the
verse number Solomon chapter 6, verse 1. Says, here therefore all ye kings are understand. Learn. He that be judges of the ends of the earth, give air he that rule the people and glory the multitude of nations. For power is given you of Yahweh, and sovereignty from the highest. Who shall try your works and search out your counsel? Because being ministers of his kingdom, ye have not judged the right, nor kept the law, nor walked after the counsel of the Most High.
Yes, yeah, so it's not all about position. It's not like how some men might run their position. This is not all about position. It's about serving the Lord Yahweh Hashem El Shai.
That's right.
In whatever position he can.
Because if you can remember with the man of Mordecai, you know what I mean? That was a real big thing. You know what I mean? That Musa actually set up things in a way that the man ended up turning out to be the boss. You know, to be the man who in charge of the scene. Because Mordecai actually set up gallows. So, man set up gallows for Mordecai. You know what I mean? So the Musa actually turned that around, that the same gallows is set up, like how the elites right now, they set up the Illuminati, the Freemasons, they set up the agenda, they set up the order. You know what I mean? That going back into Corinthians where they devise the devices.
Can.
And that is just only, recompense. That is only recompense. A righteous judgment of the Lord. to know that he could actually set up things in a way for they start to fall in their own pit. And I mean, that way, that going back to even Psalms 2, Psalms, I think it's 35. You know what I mean? With David and I was saying that how let the way be dark and slippery in our way. You know what I mean? Because just how they're setting up the new world order here, they might, it might even last. It might be next year, might even be next year. Or two years from now. You know what I mean? It might even be tomorrow, right? So you get it too.
Yeah, that's all.
But it's setting up the setting up the stuff that they can last forever. And I going back into kids and she say, devices, you know what I mean?
You know, he said that, you know, when they think about the Georgia Guidestone, when them looking to depopulate the earth, whatever the case is, when they think about it, most I kind of had a plan too, but this time it's just the whole nation of Esau gonna be wiped out. The whole nation of Esau gonna be wiped out, so the most I need the Georgia Guidestone too.
That's right!
You understand? All of Esau gonna be wiped out.
This is Daniel chapter 4 verse 17. This matter is by the decree of the watcher and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men.
Yeah, the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men, and that is spirit that I see in peace.
That's right.
That's not Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men. Right? Somebody came give me Ecclesiastes us. 17:17. Finish it.
Most High ruling
in the kingdom of men. Go ahead.
See. And giveth it to whomsoever he will.
Yeah, to whomsoever he will. The Most High is the one who moving all the plane, all the cars, moving the chest. Right? Most High is the one who doing that. Go ahead.
And set it up over it, the bases of men.
Yeah, he set up the base. The Lord set up a blasted dog to rule of us.
Right.
I love it. Go ahead.
This is Ecclesiastes 17, verse 17. For in the division of the nations of the whole earth, he set a ruler over every people.
He set a ruler over the people. The Most High did that. The Most High set a ruler over the people. Not the people choose a ruler. The Most High put in their hand aside for he to rule. Lord did that. Go ahead.
But Israel is Yahweh's portion.
Yeah, Israel is Yahweh's portion. I risked Sugar City. Most High is my king. That's why the Lord get vexed when Israel desired a king. Because the Lord is Israel king.
That's right.
You understand? The Lord is Israel ruler. Alright? Israel is the Lord's inheritance. So the Lord set all those nations. Just like when the Lord created Abraham's spirit to do with his sons, send them away. That is the Lord did. The Lord set, divide all the nations and send them away. Going back to Deuteronomy, I can't remember exactly what chapter we said. I separate you from all people, that you should be a holy people unto me.
Nah.
So the Lord sent all his sons away so that his inheritance, somebody give me Galatians 4, second to last verse. So that his where his substance could be to what? His firstborn, which is Israel.
Nah.
Okay. Alright? Galatians 4, second to last verse.
David?
Go ahead.
Galatians chapter 4, verse 30, says, nevertheless, what said the scripture?
What said the scripture? Go ahead.
Cast out the bondwoman and her son, for the son of the bondwoman shall not be heir with the son of the free woman.
Yeah, and that was Abraham's son. So he said, hey, get rid of that son, because that is not his son of the promise. So he can't be partakers of the kingdom. You understand? So get rid of him. And that is what Abraham did with all his sons. You understand? And that's the same thing with Isaac did. He Most High did actually. He set by Esau to take Jacob. Alright? So the Most High is the one who set up kings. Most High ruled in the kingdom of the earth. Sure. So what he taught that Esau have to do Jacob, the Most High put that in his hand. He said, all Syrian, the rod in thy hand is my indignation. The Most High is the one who called the shots.
That's right.
I think too, in the law, when you're saying, when the people shall indeed set up a king, shall set up a king, the Most High shall put, it's somewhere in the law. I forget.
This is Psalm chapter 66, verse 4. He said, oh, let the nations be glad and sing for joy, for thou shalt judge the people righteously and govern the nation upon the earth.
Yes, I'm talking.
Yeah, so the most